Hello and welcome to MedHead, your medical study guide in Europe. Whether it is veterinary medicine, dentistry, general medicine, everything in one channel. Different countries, different universities, we're going to explore everything. Today we have Mr. Peter with us. Thank you, Mr. Peter, for joining us. So he is the CEO of MedHead, who will be guiding us through different insights about different universities. And today's country that we are focusing is Latvia. So, Mr. Peter, give us some insight about Latvia in general as a country.
Yes, Latvia is Baltic country. It borders with Lithuania and Estonia. They have population 1.9 million of inhabitants, but the area is 64,000 square kilometers.
All right.
So the density it's of population is really low, just 30 people per square kilometer. So if you are not one of those people who enjoy being in overcrowded countries and cities, then Latvia is place for you.
The ideal place. And also it is better for in terms of like the class size, because Mr. Peter also mentioned that the class size and all these things are also comparatively smaller, so you'll get very nice focus when you're actually trying to study. By the way, there is another video linked to the description over here, which is about RSU from Latvia. Mr. Peter visited there last week on the open day, explored different career opportunities, different sort of study programs, everything, and medicine, dentistry, what are the hospitals, what are the career scope, what's the accommodation, everything. So that video is very useful as and informative as well. So Mr. Peter, first things first, what are the universities that are offering general medicine, dentistry and veterinary in Latvia?
Yes, for the general medicine, dental medicine, there are two universities.
All right.
So it's University of Latvia and Riga Stradins University. For the veterinary medicine, the name of school is so long that I will use my papers. It's Latvian University of Life Science and Technologies. So the general medicine, it takes 6 years, same as the veterinary medicine. Dental medicine is 5.
So this is very useful because many countries have dental medicine as 6 years, whereas Latvia has it 5 years. So 1 year less of fees, 1 year more of experience. So it's a good option in general. And Latvia is a part of Schengen, so you can actually move around to different parts of Europe if you want. And all the degrees, I think, are recognized in European Union and around the globe.
Yeah. What is one interesting fact is that they do not use, like it's not called ECTS credits. They have Latvian credits, which are comparable more or less to 1.5 ECTS,
okay,
but the degree and all credits are recognized, so just it's called little
and it's
bit
a
different.
Part of the European higher education system.
Yes, so everything is recognized, just the name of credits is different.
All right, that's perfectly fine. You gave us the general idea, Mr. Peter, about like general medicine, about dentistry, about veterinary. What is the admission process? Let's get down to details about each of those. So for general medicine, what is the admission process and requirements for getting at the in the university?
Yes, for the general medicine, if you wish to study at the RSU, you need to submit documents. And then for the University of Latvia, the admission is also done based on the submitted documents, but you need also to take a Zoom interview, like anyone, so also EU, non-EU, anyone needs to take the Zoom interview, 10-15 minutes. But it needs to be done before the end of June. That's why also the deadline, it's maybe 10 days before end of the June.
All right. So Mr. Peter, thanks for the information about general medicine. What about the veterinary medicine? What are the general requirements? And in general, like what's the admission process look like?
Yes. So for this veterinary medicine, you need to at least a satisfactory grade in biology, chemistry. Also, you need to present good English speaking and command of the English language.
Right.
So, for example, IELTS, you need to have at least 6.0, TOEFL 547, or score 76, and then you need to also pass the online entrance exam from biology and chemistry.
Okay, and thanks for that information. And Mr. Peter also mentioned that English is very important. So most of the universities in Latvia require an English test, a standardized, either it's IELTS or TOEFL or their in-house test, so that, you know, for embassy and visa purposes, it's easier. Mm-hmm. Mr. Peter, give us some idea about the dentist, like the dental medicine, what are the admission process requirements and so on?
Basically, it's the same. It's based on the submitted documents and you get then
the admission test. What about the fee structure for general medicine? How much is the fees annually?
Yeah, so recently there was increase at the University of Latvia. It okay. was cheaper, but nowadays like the average price it's similar, because at RSU you pay for the general medicine, you pay 12,000 euros per 1 year. You can start also in spring intake if you wish. For the University of Latvia, like the price continually goes up, so it starts somewhere around 11,300 euros and ends somewhere around 13,000 euros.
Okay, okay.
So this is for the general. For the dental, in RSU you start with 14,000 for first, second year, and okay. for the third, fourth, fifth year you pay 15,000 euros, and for the University of Latvia you pay all years you pay 15,000 euros.
Slap. What about the veterinary medicine? What's the fee structure there?
That you pay 8,000 euros each year. So okay. during all 6 years.
Okay, okay. So this is actually, if you compare it to like Western European countries, it's like much more affordable in those terms. Especially it's a part of Schengen, so you get the degree from there and then you can move anywhere you want or work over there as well. What about in general, if we speak about like the number of seats, are there limited number of seats or unlimited and they will keep on taking students?
Yeah, so for the University of Latvia, they basically take just 30 students for the general medicine.
Wow.
And maybe half of the students for the dental. So if you want to increase your chances to study medicine,
yeah,
it's better to apply for RSU, because okay. not only there are two intakes. So 360 is for the September intake and 240 is for the spring intake. So applying to RSU, you get like really big chance of getting admitted. Even for dental medicine, in 1 year there are totally 88 students being admitted, which is like, if you compare this, we talked about dental studies in Croatia, that was like 25
seats, yeah,
to 24. In Slovakia also approximately 30 seats, in Czech Republic also like, let's say 10 to 25. So 88 seats, that's a lot.
That's a lot, and that's good because you will have a good chance of getting in. But yeah, you need to like obviously pass the entrance or have the requirements met. And also with the RSU, as we mentioned in our previous video, if you don't meet the entry requirements, you can always take this open university, which is actually a pathway course for 6 months where you are actually studying to get in the university, and then you become a part of the university once you're finishing for these 6 months. What about the veterinary studies? Like, can you guide us a bit about it?
Yeah, so they take totally, it's 6 years, and in the end, like, you will get the doctor of the veterinary medicine.
Yes. And that makes sense. So, you know, in general, if you're planning to study abroad or even explore the options, it's better you start about like at least 6-7 months prior to your finishing of the high school, so that you have ample amount of time, exploration and everything, and by the time you finish your high school, get your grades and everything, you have the final decisions to be taken and final proceeding. Mr. Peter, what about like the application fees for each of these universities?
Mm-hmm. So for the University of Latvia, it's approximately 150 euros.
Okay.
University of Riga Stradins University, that's 100 euros.
What about the accommodation and living expenses in general in Latvia, though?
You can count approximately to, you need to have a budget approximately 500-600
okay.
euros. I would say this would be average, average lifestyle. There are like universities, they also provide seats, places in the dormitories.
Yeah.
Those are the most price effective, but okay. If you apply too late, you will need to find some private accommodation. Then the price might go up, but not that much, because still there are many good flights. You can even get in city center for maybe 500-700 euros for maybe 3-5 people.
Right.
Plus energies, so
okay.
That's there are like even Facebook groups where the students, they communicate and
you for can the available then, options
for the options for the flats, if they need substitute for them or they need to rent flight, then they need more people, so there are definitely these options.
Yeah, absolutely, it makes sense, and it's like a it's like very good if you take the dormitories, because initially you will have all your classmates and everyone over there. So it's good for you, you know, this last minute doing homework or like just catching up with your buddies than staying like separately. At least the first year, it's good to take the university initially. Mr. Peter, what's we already gave idea about the technicalities or let's say what's the fees and all of those things. But what is the general trend, you know, like with international students? Are there a lot of international students? Because you personally explored Latvia, mm-hmm. and are there a lot of international students, and do they like it in Latvia?
Well, we had chance to speak with the student Andras, who was from South Africa.
Okay.
Then there are like hundreds of students from Sweden, Norway, Finland, Portugal. It's mostly not only because it's close geographically, but also because of the reputation and the quality that the universities developed.
Yeah.
What is, for example, interesting, that as a student of any of these universities, you have access to the libraries of another university, so you can be student of the University of Latvia, but you can still go for the and book conference room for free in RSU library
right.
or conference room. So
that's a nice thing, actually.
Like there are more than 3,000 international students, or just of the universities in Riga. So definitely you will not be alone if you decide to follow this pathway.
And there are 70 plus nationalities, so it's like a big like really community of internationals. It's good to have international friends, local friends, everything, and it's like a support system that helps you, you know, to explore the study options and everything, the career opportunities, all the hands-on experience. So Mr. Peter, what is the unique point? Why should someone consider Latvia for any of these study options?
Mm-hmm. I would say the unique point is that you can get admitted without entrance exam. You can get admitted based on your secondary school marks. I could see in person that the equipment of the universities, I was at RSU, it's like total new or renovated. Even I spoke with one Finnish student who is studying at the University of Latvia.
No,
so
right.
I asked him like why you study there. He said because the equipment of here it's more modern and new.
Okay.
Than RSU. So after the visit, I cannot imagine like what is then at the University of Latvia, because even RSU experience was really nice. You can also, in the articles below, you can even find some pictures from the open day. So
yeah, some brochures as well we will attach. We have some brochures from there, so we're going to attach it also in the description. So do check that as well. And Mr. Peter, anything else you would like our viewers to know about Latvia or about studying these options, exploring these?
Well, there is, if you are maybe considering whether it's not too far away, there is like international airport in Riga. You can get there maybe within 25 minutes by the public transport from the city center.
Okay.
So there are like many flights to Spain, Germany. Like the flight tickets, cheapest flight ticket to Finland is like 10 euros, and Stockholm, Oslo, like you can get easily to Latvia. So I would say this accessibility of the city and of the country is really nice, and also Latvia is a country which has the highest percentage of the area which is forested.
Okay.
55%.
Wow.
So if you have something from IKEA, most probably the wood is from Latvian forest.
Okay. So thank you, Mr. Peter, for all these insights, and all the information will be there in the description. The brochures, the study programs and everything. And the most special thing that I recommend you is to reach out to Mr. Peter. His email will be provided. Give him your profile, ask him for a consultation, get a general idea of how you should proceed with your medical studies, and which universities, which countries you should target based on what you can afford, and you know, like what are your plans and so on, what's your plan A, plan B, plan C, everything. So do this consultation because it helps you, like, you know, open up the entire scope, and because we are covering almost every country from Europe in MedHead related to medical studies, it's good to explore different options. And do give it a thumbs up to our video if you liked it. Share it with your network, share it with the people who are interested to study medicine or considering some options like this to study abroad, and especially subscribe to our channel for such amazing content. Comment if you are currently in Riga, or even if you are like planning to go there, or have any questions, suggestions for our new videos, do comment it. And thank you so much for watching. Until next time, see you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.